If you're ready to use AI to streamline tasks in your life, ChatGPT is the best place to start. I'm going to show you the basics, and then I'm going to show you a powerful strategy that you can use to get precise, custom tailored results. Trust me, I'm not messing around. Let's get started. Go to chat.openai.com and either log in or create a new account. With the free version of ChatGPT, you have access to ChatGPT 3.5, and for $20 a month, you have access to ChatGPT 4.0. For now, if you're just starting out, ChatGPT 3.5 is plenty powerful enough. Start typing in the text box at the bottom of the screen to begin prompting ChatGPT. Prompting, by the way, is whenever you ask the AI to perform a task. So we can start just by asking, what tasks are you most helpful with? When prompting ChatGPT, it's important to provide as many details as possible. So let's try that first one again. Which business tasks can you help the most with? Or maybe you're the creative type. How about which design tasks can you help the most with? So if you're unsure of how to best use ChatGPT, go ahead and give it some information about you, like what industry you work in, and then ask how the AI can best help you based on your situation. But that's just the start. There are six specific types of information that we should consider sending ChatGPT to get more precise answers and answers that we're looking for. So when possible, provide ChatGPT with 1, a task. Tell ChatGPT exactly what you want. A story, math help, product suggestions, movie lists, recipes, the list goes on. 2, context. Tell ChatGPT why you need this task performed. Providing this context can help the AI give a more tailored answer. 3, an example. When you show AI an example, you're essentially giving the AI a complete template to use when it responds to your prompt. 4, a persona. Want ChatGPT to talk like a cowboy, a secret agent, or maybe a college professor? Just say so and ChatGPT will do its best. 5, a format. Specify if you want a list, a paragraph, a table, a script, an outline, or any other format. 6 is a tone. It could be fun, serious, realistic, and if you want more ideas, just ask ChatGPT. With this in mind, we can use ChatGPT for programming help, language learning, writing, business development, travel itineraries, personal coaching. The list goes on and on. As you begin prompting ChatGPT, you might not always get the answers that you're looking for. So just let the AI know in the same chat what it is about their answer that you don't like. The AI will reprocess the new information and try to give you a better answer. This process is known as reiterating, and it's an essential part of creating effective prompts with actionable results. I'll share a powerful tip to help AI create prompts for you later on, and it incorporates the idea of reiteration, so keep it in mind. It's important to note that by default, when you start a new chat with ChatGPT, ChatGPT doesn't know anything about you. We're going to change that a little bit later on, but for now, every new chat is a complete blank slate. This is both a blessing and a curse. There will be times where you wish ChatGPT could remember a few things about you and especially the way that you like certain tasks performed. But then other times you'll end up with a really chaotic chat and it will be a blessing that you can just wipe the AI's memory of that to avoid future confusion. To handle this dilemma, you'll want to start creating a prompt library. That is a place where you can store prompts to reuse again in the future. There are specific apps for this like Prompt Plus and Prompt Box, but you can just use a blank document or another productivity tool like Notion. Plan on saving several prompts and then having certain categories for them. So maybe personal prompts, work prompts, and then subcategories from there. I'm sure you see how valuable prompting is when using ChatGPT or AI. There's already a large market of people buying and selling prompts and AI workflows. And so that's where my special trick comes in. Letting AI create prompts for you. Once you've had a long, successful chat with ChatGPT where you've reiterated multiple times and worked through a task together, ask it to create a prompt based on what it's learned about you and your working style that you can reuse on other projects in the future. Reiterate the prompt that it gives you a couple times to get it more to your liking, then go ahead and copy and paste it over into your prompt library where you can make any last changes. Now you're set up to use this prompt in the future for similar projects. I'll link a starter prompt in the description of this video below that you can use for free to help you get started with having AI create prompts for you. Remember to be creative when having AI create prompts. If you've just started using AI, having AI create these prompts for you is a great way to learn how to create custom prompts yourself, because you can see what the AI is doing and then you can incorporate that in the future when you're creating your own prompts. While saving prompts is useful, don't be afraid to ditch chats that get awkward or weird. You can overprompt with AI and get some really odd results. In these situations, just delete that chat and start over from a blank slate or from a well-developed prompt in your prompt library. With all this talk about creating prompts and storing them for use later on, wouldn't it be nice if ChatGPT could just remember some things about you? Like, always? Well, it can. Click on your account menu at the bottom left and then on custom instructions. From here, there are two boxes that allow you to set some default instructions for ChatGPT to use in every new chat. In the first box, you can let ChatGPT know a little bit more about you, especially as it relates to your use of AI, so it can have more context when responding to your prompts. So maybe something like, "I'm a biochemistry student interested in study tips and techniques." In the second box, you can change the way in which ChatGPT will respond to you. So its writing style, its tone, the length of its responses, and so on. So how about use concise and simple wording? Let me know when I may be missing something important, even when I don't ask. Provide detailed responses and speak like a college professor. Notice that there's a toggle at the bottom to conveniently disable these custom instructions for whenever you want to start a new chat with a blank slate. I hope this helps you see that between custom instructions and some fine-tuned prompts, ChatGPT can be incredibly tailored to you and the specific tasks that you're looking to perform. By default, your chats with ChatGPT will be saved so you can easily go back and review old chats. You can even rename the chats to easily identify them later on. But here's something really important. While for the most part your chats are private to you, your saved chats can be reviewed by human reviewers at OpenAI, the company behind ChatGPT. This helps improve the AI, and it's pretty standard among other AIs as well, like for example Google's Gemini. Generally, your information will be de-identified when it's reviewed by humans, but it's safe to say don't enter any personal information like social security numbers, account numbers, anything like that. Alternatively, you can go to the ChatGPT settings and disable saving chats so that neither you nor a human reviewer will be able to access those chats once you've closed them out. So at this point, I hope you feel like a pretty dangerous AI user. Let me know in the comments section. And if you've ever had to sit through a long voice or video meeting and wish there was an easy way for AI to transcribe and summarize the call for you, you should check out this video right here, and I'll show you just how easy it is. If you enjoyed the video that you're watching right now, smashing that like button would really help me out. Subscribe for more. Have fun with your new AI-powered personal assistant. I'm Anson Alexander, and I will see you in the next one.